The children are going to be making their own paint from natural ingredients, similar to the method used by prehistoric artists. They'll also make a textured cave effect background using food items and glue. Using the natural objects found on their walk, or that you've provided, the children experiment with making different kinds of mark making, rubbing leaves, mud and twigs over the paper. They could even experiment with using a small amount of water to help bring out the colours. It's a good idea to get them to label what they use to create these different colours. Discuss which materials work best and then try to imagine what they might look like if they were applied to a rocky stone surface. The children are then going to make their own paints. Using a solution of flour and water, they create a smooth paste as a base for their pigment or colour to go into. The mixture needs to be not too thick and not too thin. They then add pigments, such as spices, things they found on their walk, or charcoal to create different coloured paints, experimenting with the colours they make. They will also need to spend time thoroughly mixing them in, and to not be tempted to add lots of extra water if it doesn't instantly blend. If you're using a liquid as your pigment, it can work better to use this as the paint itself, rather than mixing it into the flour and water solution. Get pupils to try both and compare the final effects. They should then experiment with their painting, making marks, shapes or symbols. To create a cave wall effect, the children simply spread PVA glue over a strong piece of cardboard, then sprinkle grains, lentils or other foodstuffs over the glue and leave it to dry. They could even use some of their homemade paints or poster paint to add colour to these backgrounds. The children should really love making their own paints and using them to create their cave wall.